Hey, what's up people? This is Zara from Kingdom 2097, and in this video we will talk about Magic Pets. So this feature has been rolled out today. Like if you go to your Eternal Knight city, you can see this new building here, Monster Forest. And if I click on this, I can see these four options here: the Magic Pet, the contracts, the summoning and the training center. So we'll talk about each of them, like what are the benefits of having these pets and how can we get them. So we will start with Magic Pet. So this is the interface where you can see all of the pets that are available and what you have already gained. So these pets are all like three types. Some are combat specific, some are sport specific, and one is for construction specific. So they will give you some buffs that will add up to your current list of buffs. For example, this one you get for free if your Eternal Knight city reaches level 20. And this one you can see it gives me infantry HP, which is at, even if this skill is at level 1, I'm getting infantry HP plus 1. This skill can also be upgraded later on. And similarly we have this anti-crit rate. So with all these monsters we have some particular buffs. This one particularly for cavalry, you can also see the packs of them. So this gives cavalry receive damage and cavalry HP as well as cavalry defense. So when we look at these monsters, we are seeing these three options here. The one which is specifying like what type it is, the second one is its promotion level, and the third one is maximum level you can have for this monster. So currently you can see that this monster is at level 2. I can increase the experience and upgrade it to a maximum of level 20. This promotion is basically, there are some skills that gets unlocked when your monster reaches a particular promotion level. For example, for this one you can see that this skill will get unlocked, infantry anti-crit rate, when my monster is at this pet is at ultimate form. So in order to promote it, I need these shards, and we will also talk about how to get these shards. So this is basically all about, you can see in this interface, like all of the skills that you are getting and what level your monster is at and what is the promotion level of your monster. Now if I come back, we have this another option here, that is summoning. So this is basically where you can get the monsters from. We can see that if I click on this plus sign here, I have four kinds of contracts: barbarism, tribe, dawn and power. So if I have these contracts, I can try to summon the monsters. I can either summon them or I can get something else. So the rewards we can see from here, for example, if I'm using Stone of Tribe, there is a 10% chance I can directly get the monster, 24% chance I can get the shards or this item which is used to increase the magic pet experience or skill. And then we have these common rewards here as well. So it is basically like any other crate opening you are doing, there is a pretty much low chance of getting these monsters directly. So for the Dawn Stone you can get these monsters, and for the barbarism you can get these ones, and for the power you have this one which you definitely get already for free. Now the question is that how do you get these contracts from? One option is definitely you can buy them from the packs. The packs are available. The second option is basically right here we can come to Magic Pet contract. Right here you can synthesize these contracts. For example, I am synthesizing currently Stone of Barbarism, and it is taking me 8 hours to complete it, and after completion I will get one summoning contract which I can use in this summoning interface to try to get to try to get any of these monsters. So I had a few because before making this video I actually wanted to learn and see how these things work, so I used up all of them. But right here you can see that I have unlocked all of these magics. Now once you have these magic pets unlocked, you have to increase their level. One way is to use the experience points, like these. You might have received some in the mails, and these are common specific. The green one can increase experience by a less amount, like it is at 945. If I use this blue one, I am getting a few less experience, with this one a little bit higher, and this one it directly increases my magic pet to level 13. So these are basically like Lord experience point and hero experience points. Either you can use the experience points to level up, or you can also try to train them. So that is for our final option, training center. If I come here and try to train any of these magic pets, it after a particular time it will increase the EXP, that is the experience point of this magic pet. And similarly you can train about 3 magic pets at a time, but the condition is that you should have 5 magic pets that should be at level 40 to unlock this slot, and similarly for this your Eternal Knight castle should be at level 25. So this is all about these pets for the time being. You have to, if we just summarize it, In order to get the magic pack, you need contracts. You can buy them or synthesize them. Once you have the contract, you can summon them. And there is a 10% chance you can directly get any of these magic pets from summoning. Once you have the magic pet, you can see them in the magic pet interface. Then your task is to level up them or promote them. To level up, you can use the experience or you can train them. And in order to promote them, you need these shards. And these shards you get from summoning. Basically, if you are not getting the monster, there is a chance of 24% to get these shards. So if you are increasing the level and if you are promoting them, it will unlock the attributes. And once the attributes are unlocked, you can also level them up to increase the attribute bonus that you are getting from them. So at this point, this is all about the magic pets that we can see in the game. There is also this Legion skill here. Not sure what it is about, because since this is currently locked, maybe we have to wait for future updates where we can see what this thing is about. So this is all about the magic pets that are currently in the game. I'm not sure like if we can send them while combats, because I tried but I was not seeing any feature where we can send these dragons for combat like we used to send our dragons. So this is pretty much basic introduction of these magic pets. Maybe in future I will make a part 2 with a detailed explanation when more things roll out. If you have any questions, as usual, you can drop them in the comments or ask me in the line group. If you are new to the channel, subscribe. If you like the video, drop a thumbs up. See you in the next video. Till then, have a nice day.